Good evening, fellow practitioners. How is everyone? 晚上好，同修们，别来无恙。Welcome to Chanting Clean Dust, the online Zen practice brought to you by Guanyin Chanting Zen Meditation Center, Singapore. 欢迎大家来到禅林启程，由观音禅林新加坡为您呈现的上线禅修。This evening, Chanting Abbot and guiding teacher Gye Mun Sunim will continue to share with us the Diamond Sutra.As well as Zen Third Patriarch Inscription of Faith. And Zen Third Patriarch Inscription of Faith will tie in with our topic for this evening. Life and death is of great importance. Impermanence is rapid. May everyone be aspired to attain no birth. Tonight is also the last session of Dharma Talk on Inscription of Faith. It is serendipitous that we end with no birth.Should you have any questions about this evening's Dharma talk or your Zen practice in general, please feel free to raise your question during the question and answer session. 那今晚呢，禅林住持与指导老师启文师父将会继续分享《金刚经》与禅宗三祖生参的信息名。那这也会连接今晚的主题“生死事大，无常迅速”，启发大家。悟无声，今晚也是信心明最后一次的开始，能以无声结尾，这也是个机缘。那开始佛法开始之后呢，如果你对今晚的佛法开始或你个人的禅修有任何的疑问，欢迎你们在问答环节时提出来。So without further ado.We will begin our practice this evening by chanting a section of the Diamond Prajnaparamita Sutra. 那事不宜迟，我们就以一段《金刚波罗波罗蜜经》的经文诵念。
所有微尘，是为多不起不提。 为尘，如来说世界，非世界，是名世界，须菩提心。可以善知恶相间，如来不不也是真，不可以善知恶相得见，如来何以故？如来说善知恶相，即是非相，是名相，是恶相。须菩提，若有真难知者，你论一本和沙本身名不是。若复有人以此经藏难知诵此世界皆等为他人说，其福甚多，何时须菩提闻说世间真切一切并类比起而来佛言稀有世尊。佛说如是真身经典，我从昔来所得慧眼为真的闻，如是至今世尊。若复有人得闻是经，心心清净，即身是相，当知是人成就第一即有功德。世尊，是实相者，即是非相。是故如来说明是相。世尊，我今得闻如是经典，请解受持，不足为难。若当来世后无伴随，即有众生得闻是经，请解受持，是人即为第一，即有何以故？知人无我相，无人相，无众生相，无受者相。所以者何我相，即是非相。人相、众生相、受者相，即是非相。何以故？离一切诸相，即名诸佛。佛告须菩提：如是如是。若复有人得闻是经，不轻不薄，不为当知是人身为其有何以故？须菩提，如来说第一波罗蜜即非第一波罗蜜，是名第一波罗蜜。须菩提，人如波罗蜜，如来说非人如波罗蜜，是名人如波罗蜜。何以故？须菩提，如我昔为隔离王，可解身体，我欲得是无我相，无人相，无众生相，无受者相。何以故？我欲往昔皆皆知皆是。若有我相、人相、众生相、受者相，念生憎恨，须菩提，有念过去离五百世，作人如仙人，离得说是无我相、无人相、无众生相、无受者相。是故须菩提，不舍因离一切相，把那妙陀罗三藐三。菩提心，不应足舍身心，不应足身相，为触发身心，应身无所住心，若心有住，即为非住。是故佛说不舍心，不应足舍不舍。须菩提，不舍为利益一切众生故，应如是不是。如来说一切诸相，即是非相，又说一切众生，即非众生。须菩提，如来是真理者，是义者，如义者，不诳义者，不异于者。须菩提，如来说的法，此法无实无虚。须菩提，若不舍心，足以发得心故事。如人如安，即无所见。若不舍心，不住发得心故事。如人有目，日光明照，见种种色。须菩提，但来之时，若有善男子，
For practicing chanting with us, 谢谢大家一起来修行念诵金刚经。So, practitioners, please may I invite you to place your palms together and greet 师父 with a sitting bow. 同修们，请大家合掌，并向师父以问讯。
大家吉祥。
Hello, everyone. Hope you're well.
谢谢大家，今晚一起上线到禅林启程。
Thank you to each and every one of you for coming online this evening to 禅林 Clean Dust.
很高兴有人在这里跟大家一起来学习探讨佛法。
I am most delighted that once again we can come together here to learn and share the Buddha Dharma.
当然我们今晚的主题要探讨的是生死四大无常迅速。
So this evening we are going to discuss the topic life and death is of great importance. Impermanence is rapid.
也就是告诉我们的生命里面什么是最重要。
So this is another way of saying in our life what is most important to you.
对。重点是怎么样了这个生跟死。
So, this it can be put conclusively that the most important thing is to liberate from death and birth.
去体会无常迅速。
And then experientially realize impermanence is rapid.
我们住的这个时间，取时间一直不自在。不断地在改变。
So we say this conventional world that each and every one of us is in are always changing, constantly changing.
这是我们要探讨的课题，怎么样找到面对外面的处境虽在改变，可是我们的真如本性是不变的。
So we have to find this thing that is not affected by the ever-changing external conditional situation and find this true suchness that is originally unchanging.
下面我们会进入再探讨，谢谢。现在我们来再回味一下，温习一下我们讲过的这个《金刚经》妙性无住分第四。
So first of all, we will do a recap of what we have discussed about Diamond Sutra, the fourth section, the sublime practice of non-attachment.
报告悉菩提菩萨，依法应无所住，心亦不思。
The Buddha said to Subhuti, Bodhisattvas, in regard to the Dharma, should have nothing to attach to and practice on giving.
若菩萨不住相而不思，其不得不可思量。
If Bodhisattvas do not attach to forms when giving, their merits and virtues are inconceivable in measurement.
须菩提，以银河东方西空可思量不？
Subhuti, what does this mean? The space in the east, is it of conceivable measurement?
不也，世尊。
No, the well-honored one.
须菩提，南西北方四维上下虚空可思量不？
Subhuti, the space in the south, west, north, the four directions, above and below, is it of conceivable measurement?
不也，世尊。
No, the well-honored one.
须菩提，菩萨无住相，不思不得，亦不如是，不可思量。
Subhuti,Bodhisattvas give with non-attachment to forms. Their merits and virtues are just like these two, of inconceivable measurement.
须菩提，菩萨单一如所教住。
Subhuti, Bodhisattvas should dwell just as they have been taught.
下面会继续讲如理四见分第五。须菩提，以银河可以生相见如来不？
So,This evening, we will also continue with a brand new section 5, which is function according to the truth. The Buddha said, Subhuti, what does it mean? Can the physical form cease the nature of just come?
不也，世尊，不可以生相得见如来。
No, the well-honored one, the physical form cannot see the nature of just come.
何以故？如来所说身相，即非身相。
How is that so? When the just come one refers to physical form, it is not the physical form.
我告诉菩提，凡所有相，皆是希望。
The Buddha said to Subhuti, all that has a form, all are delusory illusions.
若见诸相非相。则见如来。
If you see that all forms are formless, then you see the nature of just come.
以虚空为义而不解以东南西北四维上下为言者，并非显论。
To use the vast emptiness as an analogy, and to repeatedly raise up east, south, west, north, the four directions, above and below.These are actually not redundant texts.
事关要义，切不可忽。
They have important purposes. Do not neglect them.
以十方皆在虚空中，使之十法界同居，人人一念心中也。
The ten directions are all within the vast emptiness. This is to let us know that the ten Dharma realm is in the one thought of each.Of our minds.
而随即一方皆是虚空，使之随即一法当体即空。
By raising any one of the directions, all this vast emptiness, this is to let us know that by raising any of the Dharma, original substance is empty.
三，然者东南西北四维上下皆假名耳。
Thirdly,However, east, south, west, north, the four directions, above and below, all are false names.
此之我人众生乃至一切法莫非假名。
This is so we know, self, person, sentient beings, and all Dharma are none other than false names.
是，具体讲明，故事一空，言是一个。
Fourthly, since all are false names, hence vast emptiness is originally one.
此之我人众生乃至于佛种种差别。
In order for us to know that self, sentient beings, until Buddha, their various differences.
也讲明这相言之耳。
Are from the perspective of the form of false names.
也性体言则一也。
From the perspective of substance of nature, they are universally one.
故也心佛众生三如差别，故也一法界。
Hence it is said, mind, Buddha, and sentient beings, the three are not different, and it is called the one Dharma realm.
其之众生以不达一法界故，不解自动而有无明也。
It is necessary for us to know that sentient beings cannot attain the one Dharma realm due to no awareness of our own moving mind. Thus, that is ignorance.
无虽有四方而不外同一虚空。
Fifth, although there are ten directions, they do not hinder the oneness of vast emptiness.
虽同一虚空而不外有四方。
Although there is the oneness of vast emptiness,It does not hinder the existence of ten directions.
使之十法界因果深难而不爱同一性空。
This is to let us know there are dense cause and effect in the ten directions realm, and they do not hinder the oneness of nature of emptiness.
虽同一性空而不妨碍十法界因果深难。
Although there is oneness of nature of emptiness,It does not hinder the dense cause and effect in the ten directions realm.
此即显发虚空无相，而不及诸相发挥自离。
This shows the truth that vast emptiness is formless, as well as the truth that it does not reject all forms to come into play.
如此空有同时，出名自在方是虚空不可思量。
As such, emptiness and existence are simultaneous. They come and go with ease. That is the vast emptiness, which is inconceivable in measurement.
方诸以意不思而不住相，而不住相而又不思之不得，不可思量也。
Then vast emptiness can be an analogy to giving without attachment to forms. Without attachment to forms, thus give.Such merits and virtues are inconceivable in measurement.
若但言虚空乃偏空而起波裂智第一义空。
However, if by talking about the vast emptiness and therefore lean towards emptiness, how can that be the pranya or foremost truth of emptiness?
又何著因虚空不可思量也
？Furthermore, how can it be said?That the vast emptiness is inconceivable in measurement.
虽言虚空比千年东南西北是为上下者，理在已是当如是之也。
As such, to talk about the vast emptiness, we have to also talk about east, south, north, west, the four directions above and below. This is the reason. Know it just like this.
如是知者乃为正知。
To know it just like this, that is correct knowing.
即不敌菩萨无住相，不思不得，亦不如是，不可思量。
Subhuti, Bodhisattvas give with non-attachment to forms. Their merits and virtues are just like this too, of inconceivable measurement.
此方虚空无相而不爱诸相发挥，正是不思不住相。
The ten directions are of vast emptiness and formless, yet all forms come into play without hindrances. This is just like giving with no attachment to forms.
不住相而不思，正是虚空不可思量。
Give with no attachment to forms is just like the vast emptiness which is inconceivable in measurement.
菩萨能如此有而不有，空而不空，方是被称和解。
The Bodhisattvas can just like this be in existence and non-existence, empty yet not empty. That is to turn away from the dust, open to awakening.
上文言不住相不是，此处不自异，吾自大有深矣。
The above sentence talks about do not attach to forms when giving. Here, do not has been replaced with non. That is profound implication.
盖上难者上礼人，发阿耨多罗三藐三菩提心，有成佛之格。
Benevolent men and benevolent women who aspire and resolve to the Anuttara Samya Sambuddhi mind have what it takes to become Buddha.
故教以不住相布施。
This is to teach, do not attach to forms when giving.
此处教之用功，必须达到真人无著，无一丝一毫之未尽方可。
Here it is teaching that when we put in effort to practice, it is necessary to attain true non-attachment without a single trace, without a single hair of imperfection.
须菩提，菩萨当应如所教诸。
须菩提，菩提萨婆须教，just as they have been taught.
未觉到无住乃是正住。
In conclusion, non-attachment is correct dwelling.
正知因无所住，又答因因何住。
That points to should have nothing to attach to.It is also to reply on how to dwell.
上文皆说不住无住，此护言如所教诸。
The above is all about do not attach, non-attachment. Here they suddenly say, should dwell just as taught.
因为因我所自教而住。
This means, all should rely on the teachings that I have given to dwell.
明是住而无住，无住而住。不是断灭。
Clearly, that is dwell without attachment. Without attachment, thus dwell. It is not about extinction.
完但因二字，可见除依我之不住，无住外，别无他住。
To use the word should, so that we can see that besides to depend on my do not attach, non-attachment, there is no other way to dwell.
也含有降伏之意，降伏即降伏此住也。
Furthermore, that is the implicit meaning of subdue. Subdue is exactly to subdue attachment.
有但因者，因为因如我所教，自不住而边，自住而住，正是方是正住。
In addition, on the word should, this has the implicit meaning of.Should be just as I have taught about attachment. Do not attach to duality, thus dwell. That is correct dwelling.
住又有主意。
That is another key meaning to dwelling.
当您依我所教之而边，不住即修行。本以不住为主，否则非大乘佛法。
And the other key meaning is.Should depend on what I have taught about do not attach to duality to practice. Fundamentally, do not attach is the main point. Otherwise, that is not Mahayana Buddhism.
发此离相性，即不住于相两颗，相互化明。
Here, to aspire and resolve to the mind that cut through forms and do not attach to forms. These two points, they complement each other with clarity.
前年降伏即含无所住之意。
The earlier section talks about subdue, and that implies nothing to attach to.
此言不住即含降伏矣。
Here it says do not attach, that implies subdue.
故降伏即不住两事即一时。
Hence to subdue and do not attach, these two are one.
修行下手即是一个舍字。
To put effort into practicing, that is only let go.
舍不得即为自由我见。
To be unable to let go, that is attachment to my viewpoint.
我言舍即破我执。
The Buddha said, let go, that is to break through self-attachment.
此我执能舍一分，即破得一分。
As self-attachment is let go by one mark, that is to break through it by one mark.
一层一层破即。是以究竟舍我执方破境。
Layer by layer, breakthrough, self-attachment. Until absolutely let go, then the self-attachment is completely broken through.
等觉菩萨尚有一分法自为破，彼至佛国方究竟舍。
The awakened bodhisattva still has a mark of attachment to the Dharma that has yet to be broken through.Only by reaching the fruition of Buddha, then that is to absolutely let go.
故佛法自始至终只有一个舍字。
Hence Buddha Dharma, from the beginning to the end, is only the words, let go.
舍者正是不住空，不住有，即是离相心。
Let go is exactly do not attach to emptiness, do not attach to existence.That is the mind that let go of forms.
心量大道无量无边方是阿耨多罗三藐三菩提。
The mind is so great that it is immeasurable and boundless. Then that could be Anuttara Samyasambodhi.
若心量狭小又无人舍。
If the mind is narrow and small, it cannot let go.
佛不受住成佛上不住佛相。
The Buddha does not talk about attachment to become Buddha and not attached to the form of Buddha.
故禅宗祖师完全用金刚经法对邪人说半句而不说破。
Hence, Zen patriarchs and teachers completely adopted the Diamond Sutra method by only speaking to the practitioners with half sentences and do not totally let the cat out of the bag.
并斜着气势为左右不思右不思一思将妄念打得落花流水护焰脱落正是妙主。
They do this so that practitioners practice contemplation. To go left is also wrong. To go right is also wrong. Wipe out all delusory thoughts suddenly, drop and fall off in an instant that is sublime dwelling.
下面如理实践分第五，须菩提，因何可以身相见如来佛
？We will continue with session 5, function according to the truth. 须菩提 what does it mean? Can the physical form cease the nature of just come?
不言世尊，不可以身相得见如来。
No, the word honored one, the physical form cannot see the nature of just come.
何以故？如来所说身相，即非身相。
How is that so? When the just come one refers to physical form, it is not the physical form.
佛告须菩提，凡所有相，皆是虚妄。
The Buddha said to Subhuti, all that has a form, all are delusory illusions.
若见诸相非相，则见如来。
If you see that all forms are formless, then You see the nature of just come.
须菩提，因何可以身相见如来不？
Subhuti, what does it mean? Can the physical form cease the nature of just come?
古德说，菩萨当因如小所教住持一部《金刚经》，大意已尽。
The eminent teachers of the past said, until the sentence, Bodhisattva should dwell just as they have been taught.The Diamond Sutra's main purposes have been given.
以下是一重一重断疑。
From here onwards, it is the breakthrough doubts, layer by layer.
断疑故事难易犹未完足。
Of course, doubts have to be broken through. Nevertheless, it seems like the meaning and purposes are not yet completely given.
今自分可更明所以是之。
This session is to further clarify this.
茶杯斟酌
so all can avoid painstaking deliberation.
更所以然不明方有疑。
Due to lack of clarity on the reasons why, thus there are doubts.
所以然则疑自断矣。
If we know why, then doubts are naturally broken through.
生相二字就解自三十二相之应化身言。
Physical form, these two words, the old explanation all refers to the 32 forms of the adaptive transformation body.
如此，这下文三十二相岂非重复？
In this case, the latter text about the 32 forms, wouldn't that be a repetition?
金刚经 一字一句皆有声音，皆无重复者。
In the Diamond Sutra, each word, each sentence, all has profound meaning. There are definitely no repetition.
此生相二字，应救众生自本身言。
Here the word's physical form should be understood as referring to the tangible form of sentient beings.
如来二字指众生本有自法身言。
The nature of just come refers to sentient beings' innate Dharma body.
上文著作言不著相，不著者即令人会向归性也。
The above stanzas always talk about do not attach to forms. Do not attach is to help people use their form to return to their original nature.
众生自性称如来藏，是言众生本即法性。
The minds of sentient beings are called the treasury of just come. That is referring to sentient beings' innate Dharma nature.
不过藏在人我法我之中。
However, it is hidden in the treasury of person self, Dharma self.
佛教以不著相，即令众生之见所藏自如来。如此解释比较亲切。
The Buddha taught to not attach to forms. That is to help sentient beings see for themselves the hidden nature of just come. It is explained in this way as it is more approachable.
我亦若为汝等众生，仍旧生相见汝自本性也。
The Buddha's intention is as if to say, all you sentient beings can use the physical form to see your original nature.
此刻是将上来所说之理 再说明其所以然。
This session, take the teachings given before it and further clarify why the teachings are given.
上文所说种种道理，最紧要者，即反复说明不著以相而归结于，可以生相见如来一句。
The above session talks about various teachings. The most important of this is what has been repeatedly explained and clarified, which is do not attach to forms. And they all come to the conclusion of the physical form sees the nature of just come, the sentence.
上文菩萨不住相，不思其不得，不可思量。
In the above stanza, it says, Bodhisattvas do not attach to forms when giving. Their merits and virtues are inconceivable in measurement.
我已说明其故，然尚未说其所以然。
The Buddha has already clarified about this. However, he has not talked about why that is so.
盖不住一相，要点即在正性也。
Do not attach to forms. The point about it is to attain original nature.
一切凡夫从无始以来只认得一个相。
All common people, since the beginningless time, they only recognize one form.
故向外持求备成和解，将本来面目忘了。Hence,
they look outwardly to chase after things, turn their backs on awakening and connect with the dust, until original face has been completely forgotten.
上文言不著法相，不著非法相。
The above stanza talks about do not attach to form of Dharma. Do not attach to forms of non-Dharma.
法则指一切事事物物。
Dharma refers to all affairs and objects.
不能知臭皮囊是一切事物中最执着者。
Our stinky skin suits of all affairs and objects are what we are most attached to.
无始以来，即自此为生相将假作真，殊不知是无常生灭。
Since the beginning of this time, we are attached to this as our physical form. We take the force as true and do not even know that that is impermanence of birth and death.
即见解上高者知此生如幻，然上智浊喜怒哀乐已发则为情。
Those who are more realized know that this physical body is just like an illusion, yet they are still attached to the arising of joyfulness, anger, sorrow, happiness from sentient feelings.
未发而无动为性
and attached to before arising and no movement as nature.
彼为心之观，则是思，则有所禀受。
They assume that the mind organ is for thinking. With thinking, then there are sensations to deal with.
对其言不可得，以为受之以天，故应天命之为性。
Since they cannot postulate on the source of it, so they assume it is heavenly will. Hence the saying that fate is original nature.
世间皆如此见解，此与佛法完全不同。
The conventional world is full of such reasonings. This completely differs from Buddha Dharma.
彼所说无动作者，正是佛法所说自相。
What they call as no movement is exactly what Buddha Dharma referred to as forms.
佛所说之不动，这无论气罢事，是恒审思量，表面上尽是动作起灭，而性则不动。
The Buddha, when he said unmoving, that is, regardless of the seventh and eighth consciousness which is checking and thinking, on the surface, these are only the arising and ceasing of movement, yet nature is unmoving.
即喜怒哀乐亦是动作起灭。
Even joyfulness, anger, sorrow, and happiness is the arising and ceasing of movement.
如误以为未发者为性，即必为所束缚。
If we mistake that before arising is nature, we will definitely be trapped by it.
世间上至圣人，下至以夫，全是此种自责，总不外乎生灭。
In the conventional world, from the highest sages to the lowliest fools, all has this type of attachment.Always nothing but arising and ceasing.
故悉认得此不生不灭之主人翁，方可不为相转。
Hence, it is necessary to recognize the master of no arising and no ceasing, in order to not be affected by forms.
而相为我所转，不随生死无常中走，即可以了生死。
And for forms to be transformed by us, do not follow the impermanence of arising and ceasing, be liberated from birth and death.
佛令人不住相，自己用功在此。
The Buddha taught people to not attach to forms. It is imperative to put our effort here.
佛法千年万里所说亦不外此。
Of all that has been said in Buddha Dharma,All is no other than this.
本经开始即说不住相，即令我人认清此点。
This sutra, right in the beginning, already talks about do not attach to forms, so that we are clear on this point.
自相即着有，不自相即着空。
Attachment to form is clinging onto existence, not attached to forms yet attached to emptiness.
世界凡夫。是通病。
This is the common sickness of all common people.
下面我们继续发挥今晚要深入的信心明，而且讲到生死四大无常迅速。
So next, we'll continue with the inscription of faith, where we will also be covering our topic for this evening. Birth and death is of great importance. Impermanence is rapid.
信心明里面的不二法门，十方智者皆入此中。
So we are on the session of the Dharma gates of not to. The wise ones in all directions all enter from this root tradition.
十方有大智慧的人都会来从上禅宗。
In the 10 directions, everyone with great wisdom will come to admire the Zen tradition.
众非诸言一念万年。
This root tradition is not quick or slow. One thought is 10,000 years.
我们所宗上的法是超时空离概念的。
The Dharma that we uphold in respect and admiration transcend time and space.
一念一万年等无有余。
And is beyond concepts, hence one thought and 10,000 years are not different.
我们刚才讲这个生死事大无常迅速，我们请一个永嘉禅师来有一天来拜见六祖慧能大师。
So on our topic for this evening, birth and death is of great importance. Impermanence is rapid. We will use a story revolving around Yongjia, Xuanjie Zen Master, and Six Patriarchs to illustrate this point.
一天，永嘉玄觉禅师参访六祖大师，劳师散杂，正戏而离。
One day, Zen Master Yongjia Xuanjie paid the Six Patriarchs a visit. He circled the Patriarch thrice. Hit his staff with vigor and just stood there.
此也夫沙门者，即三千位，八千细行。
The Patriarch said, "You are a Buddhist seeker of the way, the embodiment of 3,000 rules of dignified etiquette and 8,000 codes of conduct."
大德自何方来深大我慢？
Great practitioners, where are you from to be of such haughtiness?
永嘉禅师说：“生死事大，无常迅速。”
Yongjia said, "Life and death is of great importance. Impermanence is rapid."
六祖说：“何不提起无生，了无数乎？”
So the Six Patriarchs said, "Why don't you attain the substance of no birth and realize that there is no rapidness?"
永嘉答：“提起无生，了本无数。”
Yongjia replied, "The substance is of no birth. Realize that originally there is no rapidness."
这个就是告诉我们，这个永嘉禅师他已经有一些物件来参访六祖，通常来见到大师应该顶礼的，可是他劳六祖慧能三照拦路顶正气而立。
So, putting this in our colloquial language, Yongjia Xuanjie Zen Master is actually enlightened even before visiting Sixth Patriarch. So usually when someone paid a visit to such a high-ranking Zen teacher, they would prostrate with respect and, deeply prostrate and bow. However, Yongjia Xuanjie Zen Master, instead of doing that, he circled the Patriarch three times, hit his staff with vigor just as shown by Shifu just now, and only stood there, not moving.
就是开始说，夫沙门者即三千位，也就是出家人要有个威仪跟规礼，看到大师来必定要顶礼，五体投地。可是呢，这个永嘉。 认为他已经证入了一些东西，所以只是正戏而立，没有去做该做的位。
So the Patriarch said, you are an embodiment of 3,000 rules of dignified etiquette, and so 8,000 codes of conduct. So when someone who is the Buddhist seeker of the way sees such a great master, they would prostrate with all their four limbs on the ground. However, Yongjia, perhaps thinking that he's really enlightened, he does not do that. Instead, he hit his staff on the ground and just stood there.
所以六祖才开口啊，大德来自何方？有这么大的我慢？永嘉说：“哎呀，生死事大，无常迅速啊，我没有来这一套礼貌啊，生死比较重要。
”So the sixth Patriarch said, "Great practitioners, where are you from to be so haughty, so arrogant?" Then Yong Jia said, "Life and death, a correct grammar correction here. Life and death are of great importance. Impermanence is rapid. I have no time for all these formalities and etiquette."
下面六祖很精彩的给他教导，何不提起无生，了无束缚
？Then the sixth Patriarch gave him a very interesting teaching. Why don't you attain the substance of no birth?And realize that there is no rapidness.
永嘉记答：提起无生，了本无数。
Then Yong Jia replied, "The substance is of no birth. Realize that originally there is no rapidness."
六祖有点认可，说：“是是，如是如是。”
So the Patriarch kind of agree with Yong Jia, and he said, "Just like this, just like this."
也就是说，有生即有死，生死即无常。
Which means, where there is birth, there is death. Birth and death is of impermanence.
故禅师问此事。
Hence, the Zen master asks about this.
六祖开始说：“何不自戒体悟无生之理
？”So therefore, the sixth Patriarch said, "Why don't you realize?" Directly. Okay, so why don't you directly realize the truth of no birth?
永嘉的领悟便说：自性空，体本无生无灭呢，了悟本来无数无次。
So Yong Jia realizes his intention and said, "The substance of original nature is empty, no birth, no death." Realize that originally there is no rapidness, no slowness.
对六祖有点。内在闷咳就说：“是的，如是如是，就是如此。”
The sixth Patriarch approves of him silently, and he said, "Yes, it is just like this."
然后人家就礼拜后就要离开告辞。
So after this, Yong Jia bowed deeply, and he informed that he will leave soon.
就是说，哦，怎么这么快？反太束缚。
Then the sixth Patriarch said, "You are going back so quickly."
永嘉答：“本自被动，哪里有快跟慢？岂有速也？”
Yong Jia replied, "Original mind is unmoving. How would that be quick and slow? How can it be quick?"
六祖在试探说。
Then the Zen sixth Patriarch asked again,
这样就走不会太快吗？
"You are going back so quickly. Isn't that too soon?"
永嘉答：“自性本无来去，哪有快慢之别呢
？”So Yong Jia replied, "Original mind is unmoving. How can it be quick?"
那有快跟慢的分别
？Where is the distinction between quick and slow?
六祖在问：“谁知非动
？”So the sixth Patriarch asks again, "Who knows about unmoving?"
永嘉答：“仁者自胜分别。”
Yong Jia replied, "Patriarch, you have given rise to distinction."
就是说，哎，你省得无生之意啊。
So then the sixth Patriarch said, "You have already attained the meaning of no birth."
永嘉答：“无生哪里有意呢
？”So Yong Jia replied, "How can no birth have meaning?"
无生有什么意啊？就走大无意，谁分别？
So the sixth Patriarch said, "Who is making the distinction that there is no meaning?"
永嘉回答：“分别亦非。”
So Yong Jia replied, "This distinction is also does not come from thinking."
是也尚在，少留一宿。
The Patriarch said, "Sadhu, please stay for one night."
是为一宿节，后着正道各圣行一时。
From here on, he was known as One Night Enlightenment. Later, he composed a Song of Enlightenment, which was famous throughout the world.
So, 六祖慧能留他住一晚，他留宿一住，就住一晚就开悟了，叫做上斋少留宿，十位一宿结束，住一天就开悟。后来永嘉禅师很出名，做了一个正道歌圣性仪式，下面我们会有机缘我们会再继续讲这个正道歌。
So the patriarch asked Yong Jia to not go away so quickly, but to stay on for one night. And because of this one night stay with the patriarch, he was therefore known as One Night's Enlightenment. Later, he composed a Song of Enlightenment, which was famous throughout the world. And we will also be sharing this Song of Enlightenment in chanting clean dust. Please look up for it.
下面讲无在不在十方目前。
Omnipresent, the ten directions are right before our eyes.
因为法是统时空，亦无我普遍存在的。
As the Dharma unifies time and space, object and I are one, all pervasive.
所以十方目前毫无间隔。
Hence the ten directions are right before our eyes.
即小同大妄觉境界。
The minuscule is the same as the great, completely forget about all conditional situation.
即小佛经叫它叫虚灵，即接近无的意思，也就是现在科学、自然科学讲的原子，肉眼是看不见的。
Minuscule, Buddhist sutras refer to it as negligible. That means it is almost nothing. That is also what modern natural science called atom.We cannot use the physical eyes to see it.
极小看不见，那大宇宙你也看得见吗？
It is too minuscule to be visible. In that case, can you see the great universe?
也看不见，所以说极小同大妄觉境界。
You cannot see it too. Hence it is said minuscule and great are the same. Forget about conditional situation.
极大同小，不见边表。
The greatest is the same as the small, see no dividing line.
极大同小也看不见边缘和表象了。
The greatest is the same as the small, so we cannot see the edge and its representation.
有即是无，无即是有。
Existence is nothingness, nothingness is existence.
有从无来，无因有显。
Existence is from nothingness. Nothingness manifests as existence.
如果有是有，无是无，这个大宇宙如同一潭死水。
If existence exists, nothingness is nothing. The great universe is just like one dead lake.
再没有创造的生机和发展的可能了。
There is no longer.Any possibility of creative life force and growth?
那还算是无尽藏吗？
In that case, is that still the infinite treasury?
而且基于不二的义谛，有无只是一种妄词罢了。
Furthermore, based on the truth of not to, existence and nothingness are merely types of attachment. That's all.
若不如此，彼不悉所。
If it is not as such, no need to abide by it.
若非如此，什么是不二法门的准则呢？
If it is not as such, what is the teaching of the Dharma gate of not to?
义即一切，一切即义，但能如是，何利不彼？
One is everything. Everything is one. If we can be just like this, why worry about no attainment?
性空则缘起，缘起则性空。
The nature of emptiness is dependent origination. Dependent origination is the nature of emptiness.
万万种差别来自一个本源。
All the various differences come from the same original source.
这叫做万书一本，一本万书。
This is called all differences are originally one. One source is many differences.
但作如是观，自然别无甚意了。
Just like this, contemplate one-pointedly. Naturally, there is nothing left.
性性不二，不二性性，一言道断，非起来经。
Faith is not two, not two this faith. Cut off all speech and language. No past, future, no present.
但信心外有法，唯存一心。
Only have faith that there is no Dharma beyond the mind, and that is only one mind.
便是究竟行门。
That is the ultimate teaching.
道是言语所不能表达的，也不属于过去、现在和未来。
The way cannot be expressed by words and speech. It also does not belong to the past, present, and future.
它是原本如此，普遍如此，又毕竟如此。
It is originally just like this, universally just like this, and ultimately just like this.
就是性性名的总结，就是法尔如是。
And to conclude, inscription of faith is the Dharma is only just like this.
好，下面是时间是大波，大家有疑问、有问题问吗
？So actually, we have already reached the end of our practice this evening. Can we just do a quick check? Do any one of you have any questions?
OK, 没有问题，好，大家已经觉悟了。
No question is great. Every one of you are enlightened.
众生无边誓愿度。
Sentient beings are numberless. We vow to save
them. 烦恼无尽誓愿断。
Delusions are endless. We vow to cut through them all.
法门无量誓愿学。
The teachings are infinite. We vow to learn them all.
佛道无上誓愿成。
The Buddha way is inconceivable. We vow to attain it.
谢谢大家的聆听。
Thank you everyone for listening. Thank you everyone for joining our practice. So happy to see some of the familiar faces here this evening. Buddha Dharma is indeed wonderfully meticulous. Original nature is neither sensation of joyfulness, anger, sorrow, and happiness, nor before joyfulness, anger, sorrow, and happiness.How sublime is Buddha's middle path? 那佛法是如此的清晰，真性不是喜怒哀乐的感受，也不是喜怒哀乐的未发。佛法教导的中道太微妙了，我们就以这个微妙的教导向大家说声晚安。And with this, good night, everybody.